What's going on, everybody? It's ETA Prime back here again with another LaunchBox news video. Today, we're releasing LaunchBox version 13.23 for Windows. And just like all of our releases, we've got fixes, improvements, and new features. I want to start out here with a new premium Big Box feature that we've had a lot of people asking about for quite some time, and that's Screensavers in Big Box. So getting right in here to the new Screensaver feature in Big Box. This is really awesome. So you can see it just swapped over to the Screensaver. It's just going to choose a random game. Press A to explore. So once we're here, we can actually move over to the game's details page. There's quite a few settings that we can actually change. And if you want to totally disable it, it's up to you. These new Screensavers are fully themeable, so theme developers can incorporate these into their new upcoming themes. And there's a lot of settings that we can change here. From our system menu, we're going to go down to Options. We've got a new Screensaver section. So you can totally disable it if you don't want it there. It's up to you. View, Ambiance, Gallery, Spotlight, Theater. We'll go with Gallery. I've set my wait time to 10 seconds, but we've got up to 30 minutes here. I'm going to leave it right there. Minimum time between games, 30 seconds, maximum time. So you can set both of these up to 10 minutes, but I'm going to go with 30 seconds on both of these just to make it a little easier on me, to kind of swap through them quickly. Skip games missing background image, skip games missing box art, and you can also skip games missing videos. So I went to gallery, let's move back. And each of these do give you a different look. So this is gallery. We've got our box art over on the left-hand side. Nice little video over on the right-hand side. This one does look great. Next up, we've got spotlight. A little simpler, but it will swap over to that video for us. But my favorite one is theater. So it does give us that nice little screensaver. Then it moves into more artwork. We've also got that video playing. Just a lot more going on here. And yeah, I gotta say that this is the one that I'm gonna keep on my system. But yeah, having these screensavers is really awesome with LaunchBox. And again, you can explore that game. So let's say you've got a cab set up or you got this running on your PC. See a game running here. You can go ahead and press A. It'll bring you right over to that game. So you can learn more about it or go ahead and start playing it. And another thing we have here is the ability to set up a hotkey so we can actually just go directly to those screensavers so we don't have to wait. You can do this with your keyboard or your controller. We'll go to Options. Down here, again, you can set a keyboard or controller. I'll go with keyboard. Start screensaver. Got it set up as H on my keyboard. And at any given time, it's going to go right into that screensaver for us. Another awesome new feature we have with this update is a brand new welcome wizard. If you're a new user or an existing user, this is going to allow you to get up and running faster than ever. And if you've been using LaunchBox for quite some time, you've probably never seen this. This is our brand new welcome wizard. Welcome to LaunchBox. I just set this up in a separate location. It's a brand new install of LaunchBox. We'll choose next here. Do you have any games? I can add my folder from here. So I'm going to go to my desktop. I'm just going to add this folder. I've got one system set up ready to go there. So we'll select folder. You see, I already found that. I've got Sega Genesis right in there. We'll choose next. We can also log into all of the storefronts. So if you want to log into your Amazon Games account, EA, Epic Games, GOG, Steam, Ubisoft, Xbox, you can do it from here. But remember, LaunchBox is automatically going to scan default locations. So if you do have PC games installed on your system, it will detect them and import them automatically. So if you don't want to log in, you don't have to. We'll choose next. Make my games look awesome. Main group, four groups. We want the clear logos, backgrounds, screenshots. You can do the 3D models if you want to, and I'm actually going to do these. I love those. Down here, we've got even more to choose from. So media, you can go with the cart front, back, disc, fan art, cart 3D. It's up to you. If you've got a LaunchBox Games database account, you can sign in from here. Key and additional functions, LaunchBox high score leaderboards, and retro achievements. If you want to use retro achievements, once you set this up, you can sign in now or you can always wait till later. So it's a more comprehensive installer, makes it easier for everybody to get this set up. And once it starts up for the first time, it's automatically going to download all of our artwork, import our games. It's going to get that metadata downloaded for us. And you can see I've already got some PC games here because they're installed on my computer right now. So it scanned those default directories for me. Give it some time to finish up. And there it is. So I've got my computers, so my Windows games, consoles. I've just imported one. We've got Sega Genesis. But yeah, the new Welcome Wizard is awesome, especially for new users. You can get everything set up, ready to go super easily. Another thing we've done with this release is the legacy video player engine that we used to use, VLC, has finally been replaced with FFMPEG. So WMP is lighter and more robust overall, but FFMPEG is still a good alternative to be used. It's more plug and play versus WMP, because WMP requires that Windows has WP enabled, and if it's not, then it's just not going to work out. So we're using FFMPEG. Another thing I wanted to do here was give Dan Patrick a big shout out because he recently updated the Nintendo GameCube, Nintendo Game Boy Advance, and Pico 8 platform icons for this release. They're more color accurate and available with this update. So a big shout out to Dan Patrick for doing that for us. But that's going to wrap it up for this release. If you're interested in checking out the changelog, link will be in the description below. Keep an eye out because we've always got new stuff on the way. And like always, thanks for watching.